I got a call from one of my business partners yesterday, and she was very, very down, depressed, sad on life. And I asked her, I said, you know, tell me, what's wrong? What's going on in your world? And here's what she said. She said, you know, Brandon, I'm very sad on life right now. I just don't feel that I have the strength to keep going on anymore. I don't feel that my life is worth anything. In fact, the only thing that's keeping me going are my children. And she's a single mother. And she felt that life has it out for her. Life is beating her down. That nothing positive is happening in her life. Then when she goes to work, her boss is always on her back. Her co-workers are spreading lies and rumors about her. The men in the office are only trying to get in her pants and lying that they have to the other guys that spread more rumors. Her parents aren't very supportive of her because they didn't support the decisions she made in her life to get to this point. Her friends smile in her face but stab her in the back. There's more month left than money because the money runs out before the month is up. She's not able to purchase the things she wants for her children. There's some nights she has to struggle just to put food on the table. She doesn't feel pretty. She doesn't feel worthy. She feels ugly. She feels like there's nobody who appreciates her because she doesn't even appreciate herself. She doesn't feel that there's a way out to change this situation. And I told her, I said, well, let's talk about your relationships. What about the men in your lives? And she said that that doesn't go very well. Beyond the physical, that there's nothing else. That it seems like all the men want to use her for is just for sex. And I love to do this, and I've done this before, and I've heard it before, but I ask her a simple question. I said, let me ask you a question. Let's just deal with your relationship first. What is it that you want in a man? And she says, you know, I don't want a man who treats me bad. I don't want a man who stays out late at night. I don't want a man who goes drinking and smoking with the buddies. I don't want a man who does drugs. I don't want a man who treats me bad in front of my children. I don't want a man who cheats on me. I don't want a man who physically and verbally abuses me. I don't want a man who tells me that I'm ugly, who tells me that I'm fat, who tells me that I'm no good, who tells me that I'm not worth living, who tells me that I'm no good for anybody, and that I'm lucky to just have him. I don't want a man who makes me feel like dirt. Now that sounds logical, right? Who wants a man that makes her feel that way? And I asked her that question, how does that make you feel? It makes me feel horrible, makes me feel bad, makes me feel like I'm not worth anything. I said, but you never answered my question. So what do you mean? I said, what is it that you want in a man? She said, I answered that. I told you what I said. Nah, you said, you told me what you don't want. Tell me what you want. See, instead of telling me what you don't want, how about this? You want a man who treats you good. You want a man who makes you feel right. You want a man who loves you and respects you. You want a man who treats you like a princess and a queen. You want a man who respects you in front of your children. You want a man who wants to come home and spend time with you and not the buddies. You want a man who will give you massages, who will make you feel good. You want a man who will make you feel beautiful. Now, what's the difference between the two? The difference is, you're now talking about and thinking about what you want, because how does that make you feel to have a man like that? It makes me feel like I'm worth something. It makes me feel like I'm loved. That's a good feeling, isn't it? So to change your current circumstances, You begin by changing your feelings. You begin by changing your thought process. You begin by changing how you look for yourself. And she says, but it's hard for me. I said, well, let me help you out. Because guess what? You're beautiful. You're beautiful on the inside and the outside. Don't let anybody tell you that you're not beautiful. And this goes for all the women out there. You're beautiful. You have value. The world is better with you being here. Your children love you. Other people love you. You are respected. You are powerful. You're God's gift to this planet. If you don't believe it, believe what I'm saying to you. You are beautiful. You're gorgeous. You're desirable. You're wanted. You're special. You're loved. The world smiles when you smile. The world is a better place when you're happy. Hard times come, but hard times come to pass. They're not here to stay. Whatever your current situation is, it is temporary, not permanent. Good times are ahead. Your season is ahead of you. You're a beautiful person. And before the rest of the world can believe that, you must believe it yourself. And if you can't believe it yourself, believe what I'm telling you, that you're beautiful. You are here for a purpose. And you're not finished yet. Smile. Be happy. Know it from within. And I'm going to tell you what's going to start to happen when you start to believe this yourself. It's going to start to manifest itself in your life. Don't worry about the rent. Don't worry about the bills. Don't worry about what he said and she said. Don't worry about what mom and dad have to say. Don't worry about what your friends or so-called friends say. Don't worry what that guy says or what that girl thinks about you. You are beautiful. And you believe that, everybody else will start to believe it as well. It may not happen overnight, but it will happen. But I'm here to tell you that you're beautiful. I'm here to tell you that you're worth something. I'm here to tell you that you're going to change the world one step at a time. I'm here to tell you to stop crying, get up on your feet, and make a difference. I'm here to tell you that the Lord made you an independent, unique creature, different from everybody else, and that in itself makes you unique. You are a blessing, and you have a purpose. And above all else, go in the bathroom, look in the mirror, smile, and tell yourself that you're beautiful. Bye-bye.